Hello children, welcome to the next session, session number 25, chapter 2, we are discussing the bit number 3, verify the values of x given in each case are the 0 of the polynomial or not. In the previous session, session number 24, I explained the first two questions. Next I am going for the third question. So it's a continuation, since it was a continuation, so what is the 0 of a polynomial means? He will give one polynomial and he will give one value. So we have to substitute that value. And if we get a 0, then we can say that it is the 0 of polynomial. If it is not a 0, then we have to say that it is not a 0 of the polynomial. Right? So already I have mentioned a statement to write. So what is the statement? We have to substitute the given value in the given polynomial. If we get a 0, then we can say that is a 0 of polynomial. You write that statement. Now I am going for this one. What is this given? X is equals to plus or minus 1. So means it has two values. So one is x is equals to plus 1 and x is equals to minus 1. Plus or minus 1, both values are given. So let us check whether it is 0 or not. So what is the first? P of x is equals to x square minus 1. Now first what I have to do? P of 1. So P of 1, what is that? 1 square minus 1. What is 1 square? 1 into 1. So that is 1 minus 1, that is 0. We got 1 minus 1 cancelled, 0. So therefore, P of 1 is the, what I should write, is the 0 of polynomial. Next, second one I am going. P of x is equals to x square minus 1. Now what I should write? P of, what I should check? Minus 1. So what I will get? Minus 1 whole square minus 1. So what is minus 1 whole square? Minus 1 whole square means minus 1 into minus 1. So what is minus 1 into minus 1? It is plus 1. So therefore this is plus 1 minus 1. So plus 1 minus 1, what I will get? 0. So therefore P of minus 1 is 0 of polynomial. Okay, so how many 0 of polynomials we got? 2. So let's recall the past one. What is the degree of the polynomial? 2. So therefore how many zeros it will have? 2 zeros it will have. So what are the zeros of this one? Is plus 1 and minus 1 are the 0 of the polynomial of this polynomial. What is this? X square minus 1. Okay, next I'll go for the next question. Question number 4, I hope. This is the question number 3. Next, I will go for the question number 4. Right. The question number 4 is P of x. So, what is the polynomial? P of x is equals to x minus 1 into x plus 2, and we have to check whether what are the values. X is equals to minus 1, x is equals to minus 2, or minus 1 comma minus 2. We have to check whether they are the zeros of the polynomials or not. Okay, so it's very simple. Answer: given P of x is equals to x minus 1 into x plus 2. Now first what I am doing is P of minus 1. We can do in two methods. I will go for the regular method, this one. Next I will tell one more method. If you are interested, you can do that method also. Now P of minus 1, that means whenever x is there, I have to write minus 1. So what will get? P of minus 1 is minus 1 minus 1. Why minus 1 minus 1? Because x is minus 1 and this is minus 1. Next, into minus 1 plus 2. So what is minus 1 minus 1? Don't cancel it. Minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2. When both minus are there, add and keep minus symbol. And next, minus 1 plus 2. This is plus 1. And when, what is the meaning of brackets? Multiplication. So minus 2 into plus 1. You will get minus 2, which is not equal to 0. So therefore p of minus 1 is not a zero of polynomial. Is not a zero of polynomial. Okay. Next, same one. P of x is equals to x minus 1 into x plus 2. Next, what I am doing? P of minus 2. What is P of minus 2? That means whenever x is there, I have to write minus 2. What I have to write? Minus 2 minus 1 into minus 2 plus 2. What is minus 2 minus 1? Yes, it is minus 3 into 0. Why 0? Plus 2 minus 2 may cancel. So what is minus 3 into 0? 0. Yes. Therefore, yes, P of minus 2 is 0 of polynomial. Got it? So that means in this case it's not a 0. And in that case it says 0. So already informed, I will tell in one more method. So what is that method is, first of all, x minus 1 into x plus 2 is given. We have to write in the standard form. So what is the standard form of a polynomial? Ax square plus bx plus c. So how to write that one is very simple. So p of x is equals to x minus 1 into x plus 2. What I have to do is, I have to multiply this term with these two, then this term with these two. So what you get is x into x, x square, x into 2x, minus 1 into x, minus 1 into plus 2, minus 2. So what you get? X square plus 2x in plus 2x minus x, plus x minus 2. So then you have to substitute. So what is that first? P of minus 1. So this is the P of x. Of course, you will get the same answers, but instead of writing x minus 1 into x minus 2, x plus 2, you can also take this as the polynomial. Both are same. Now P of minus 1, what happened? Minus 1 whole square plus minus 1 minus 2. And then what will you get? Minus 1 whole square is plus 1. Minus 1 whole square is plus 1. Minus 1 into minus 1. Minus 1 minus 2. Minus minus cancel. What I got? Minus 2, which does not equal to 0, which is not a 0 of polynomial. Then next, P of minus 2. What I will get? Minus 2 whole square, because x square, plus minus 2 minus 2. What is minus 2 whole square? Minus 2 whole square means minus 2 into minus 2. It is plus 4. Minus 2 minus 2. What is minus 2 minus 2? Yes, it is minus 4. Plus 4 minus 4 may cancel. It is 0. So therefore, it is 0 of polynomial. So you can do in the direct method, or you have to write in this one and you can proceed. Of course, you will get both answers are the same. Which you feel comfort, you can write. No need to wrap it, go for this particular method only. So some students may not understand this multiplication, how to multiply that. So this was discussed in your 8th class, how to write that one. You have to follow that. If you are good in that, then you can do this. Otherwise, you can go for a normal regular method, what I have explained previous. Okay, next, I'll go for the next question. What is the next question? Question number 5. It's very simple. Given P of y is equals to y square, and y is equals to 0. Y is equals to 0. What happens? Simply given, this is the question and answer I am writing. P of y is equals to y square. Now I want P of 0. What happened? 0 square. 0 square means 0 into 0. So therefore it is 0. So therefore P of 0 is the 0 of polynomial. That's all. Next, I will go for one more question. P of x. P of x is equals to, what is given? Ax plus b and x is equals to minus b by a. X is equals to minus b by a. How to write? So very simple. First, given p of x is equals to ax plus b, and p of minus b by a. So how to write? Wherever x is there, I have to write minus b by a. What I have to write? A into minus b by a plus b. So nothing is there, 1. So a into minus b by 1 into a plus b. What happens? A cancel. And what will get? Minus b by 1 is nothing but b minus b plus b. So minus b plus b cancel, it is 0. So therefore, p of minus b by a is the 0 of polynomial. Is the 0 of the polynomial. Okay. Next, I'll go for the next question. Question number 6, I hope. So this is already we have discussed in the general form of a linear form. 0 of a polynomial. 0 of a linear polynomial. So what is the general form of a linear polynomial? P of x is equals to ax plus b. So what is it? 0 minus b by a. The same thing it was discussed here. Next. Good question. Question number 7. Try to practice these type of questions by your own. F of x is equals to 3x square minus 1. And x is equals to minus 1 by root 3. And second thing is 2 by root 3. We have to check whether they are zeros of the polynomial or not. So straightly I am going to the question. Answer. F of x is equals to 3x square minus 1. First I am going to take f of minus 1 by root 3. Be careful. Minus also given in the question. If it is not plus 1 by 3, it is minus 1 by 3. That means whenever x is there, I have to write minus 1 by root 3. So what will get? So 3 into minus 1 by root 3 whole square minus 1. Next, what happens? Minus 1 by root 3 whole square means what? Minus 1 by root 3 whole square means minus 1 by root 3 into minus 1 by root 3. What happens? Minus 1 into minus 1, it is plus 1. Then next, root 3 into root 3 is root 3 whole square. Square root may cancel, it is 1 by 3. So you have to write like this, 1 by 3. So that means it, what happens? It is 3 into 1 by 3 minus 1. Next, what happens? 3, 3 may cancel, you will get 1 minus 1. What is 1 minus 1 may cancel? It is 0. So therefore, what is the answer? F of minus 1 by root 3 is 0 of polynomial. We got it or not? Yes, we got it. So here is the key step. Minus 1 by root 3 means we have to write in this way. Okay? Next question, what is that? We have to do 2 by root 3. Now let us check whether 2 by root 3 is 0 of polynomial or not. The same method we have to follow. So what is this method? F of 2 by root 3. Now what happens? Same. 3 into 2 by root 3 whole square minus 1. What is 2 by root 3? 2 by root 3 whole square means what I have to write? 2 by root 3 whole square is equals to 2 by root 3 into 2 by root 3. What will get? So 2 into 2 by root 3 into root 3, root 3 whole square. What is 2 into 2? 4, square root may cancel, it is 3. 4 by 3. So what I write is 3 into 4 by 3 minus 1. So next, if nothing is there, 1. So 3 into 4 by 1 into 3 minus 1. 3, 3 may cancel, you will get 4. 4 by 1 is 4. 4 minus 1 is 3, which does not equal to 0. So therefore, what we should write? Therefore, P of 2 by root 3 is not a 0 of polynomial. Not a 0 of polynomial. That's what you have to write. Good question, this one. So, think how to do and how to substitute. And last, I'll go for the next question. Almost our 15 minutes is finished. Next, I'll go for the last question. By this, I'll stop this session. So, question number 8. So, what is this? F of x is equals to 2x minus 1. Now, what we have to do? X is equals to 1 by 2 and minus 1 by 2. So, we have to check whether these two are zeros or not. Okay? So, by looking this, we can say it is a linear polynomial. So, what is the general form of linear polynomial? Ax plus b. So, what is that? Minus b by a. So, between these two, it's clearly that this is not a zero of polynomial, this is zero of polynomial. How to do that one is? Sorry, this is the zero of polynomial, this is not. How to do? Let us check. F of 1 by 2. What happens? 2 into 1 by 2 minus 1. Because whenever x is there, I have to write 1 by 2. What is the next one is 2 into 1 by 1 into 2 minus 1, because if nothing is there I can write 1. So 2 to my cancel, 1 by 1 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. So therefore f of 1 by 2 is 0 of polynomial. Now the same question, f of minus 1 by 2, let us check. So f of x is equals to 2x minus 1. Now it will be f of minus 1 by 2. What happens? So 2 into minus 1 by 2 minus 1. What will you get? So 2 into minus 1 by 1 into 2 minus 1. So 2 to make cancel, I will get minus 1 by 1 minus 1. What is minus 1 by 1? It is minus 1 minus 1. So don't cancel it. We have to cancel only when 1 is plus, 1 is minus. If nothing symbol is there, it is plus, we can cancel this. But we should not cancel it. What is its answer? It is minus 2, which does not equal to 0. So therefore, f of minus 1 by 2 is not a 0 of polynomial. Okay? That's all. So by this question is finished. Exercise 12.2, 2.2, question number 3 is finished. So still we have 3 more questions. We'll discuss in the next session. After that, very 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 important aspect of this chapter, dividing polynomials and factorizing polynomials. These two are very important questions where the student talent, where the student capability clearly enhances, and clearly the output of the student talent is exposed. That's all. So today's homework is this 6 questions. Write it neatly and don't forget to write the statement for each and every question. You have to write that statement. What is the statement? When we have to find the zeros of a polynomial, we have to substitute the given number in the given polynomial. If we get 0, that is the 0 of polynomial. Otherwise, it is not a 0 of polynomial. Right? And you have to write the conclusion also. That's all. That's all for this today's session, and we'll meet in the next session with new topic. Thank you.